When you look up at the moon night after night, it appears to slowly change shape. These changes, known as phases, are repeated every month. This is because they depend on where the moon is in orbit around the Earth, a journey that takes 29 and a half days. Notice that half of the moon is always lit up by the sun, and that half is always in shadow. From Earth, we see different amounts of the bright side at different times of the month. This is what causes the phases of the moon. When the moon is on the same side as the sun, we can only see its shadowed side. We call this a new moon. As the moon moves along its orbit, we see more and more of the bright side. The moon appears to grow, and we say that it's waxing. At first, we can only see a thin sliver of the light that reflects off the moon. We call this a waxing crescent moon. When the moon reaches a quarter of the way around its orbit, we can see half of its bright side. We call this the first quarter moon. As the moon continues, we see more than half of its bright side. We call this a waxing gibbous moon. When the moon reaches the halfway point on its orbit around the Earth, we can see the whole lit up side. This is a full moon. On the second half of the moon's journey, we see less and less of its bright side. We say that the moon is waning. First, we see a waning gibbous moon, where we can still see more than half of the bright side. When the moon reaches 3/4 of the way around the Earth, we again see half of the moon lit up. This time, it's called the third quarter moon. We then see less than half of the moon, called a waning crescent moon. Finally, we see another new moon, and the cycle begins again. I hope that now you won't be phased by the phases of the moon.